Hey guys, in this video I'm going to go over this path analysis problem. We're given a correlation matrix and this simple structure, and we're asked to solve for the letters in the structure A, B, C, D, and E. So we're given the correlation between two variables and we want to be able to find these direct correlation coefficients. So just using the correlation matrix that we're given and Wright's path analysis rules, we'll be able to solve for A, B, and C, and then you solve for D and E using another equation. So let's go ahead and solve for A, B, and C first. So we're going to use Wright's path analysis rules to find the correlation B, C, B, D, and CD. The correlations between B and C, there's C, which is the direct correlation, and then we can also do BA, and that's it for the correlation between B and C. Next, we're going to do the correlation between B and D. So B and D, so we can do BA, and we cannot go forward and back. That violates one of the rules. So BD correlation is just BA. And then the correlation between C and D, we have A squared, and we can go back and then through the bidirectional arrow and then forward. So that's CBA. Okay, so those are three equations that we can get from the structure. Now let's use the information that we're given in the correlation matrix. So I can already tell that BA is a part of both RBC and RBD. So let's go ahead and plug this in. So RBC, if we look at the matrix, that's equal to 0.7, and this is equal to C plus BA. RBD, so BD, that's 0.3, is equal to BA. So that means that BA is equal to 0.3. So solving for C, we get that C is equal to 0.4. So that's our first correlation coefficient that we found. And I'm going to plug it in here. So plugging in for everything that we found already, we have this. And now let's use that to find A. So RCD is 0.48, which is equal to A squared plus CBA. We have that C is equal to 0.4 and that BA is equal to 0.3. So solving for A squared, that gives us that A squared is equal to 0.36, which means that A is equal to 0.6. So we have 0.6 here and 0.6 here. And now we can solve for B. So RBD is 0.3, that's equal to 0.6 times B, which means that B is equal to 0.5. And so now we just have E and D that we need to find. What we're going to do is use a variance formula or explained variance, and we're going to take the square root of 1 minus the variance explained, and this will give us a value for D and for E. So D is a little bit more simpler than C because this only has A pointing to it, the variable D. So if we do the variance of AD, this is going to be equal to A times RAD, and RAD is just A, so this is equal to A squared, which we already know is equal to 0.36. So D is going to be equal to the square root of D squared, which is equal to the square root of 1 minus 0.36, which is equal to 0.8. And now for the more complicated example, we have the explained variance of C and AB, because A and B are pointing to C, but only A points to D. And this is equal to A times RAC plus C times RBC. So this is the coefficient C times RBC plus the coefficient A times RAC. So this is equal to 0.6 times 0.8 plus 0.4 times 0.7, which is equal to 0.76. So E is equal to the square root of E squared, which is equal to 1 minus 0.76, which is equal to 0.49. And now we are done with this problem.